So I've had some time to think about this. I mean, it's only been out for like a week and a half, like 2 weeks now. But the whole Pokemon Go debate, I mean, we haven't seen anything take over and become an overnight success the way this thing has. Like, it took the world by storm, and it's kind of crazy. So, you know, there's been a lot of pros and cons and people saying it's stupid and everybody's on it and it's distracting and whatever. So, personally, I just want to say I don't play it, you know, like, I tried it and it's not really for me. Like, I got into it, I get it, but it's not my thing. But I want to say that I will defend it against all the naysayers because the pros definitely outweigh the cons, and the cons don't hold, you know, they don't, the argument doesn't hold weight. So what are people saying? You know, it's for kids. It's, you know, you're a grown ass person, you shouldn't be playing it. Well, you know, you're also going to the movie to see X-Men and Batman and the Avengers, which are all, you know, once upon a time were considered to be kid things, you know, and the older generation is now gamers, and the biggest gamer, you know, age range is like between the 20s and 40s, you know, so that doesn't hold weight. You know, you grow up with these things, you know, and what you choose to do at whatever age is your business, you know, so that's subjective. Now, the biggest one, you know, it's dangerous. You know, there's kids walking out into the street and they're not aware of their surroundings and all this shit. And, you know, that's just a problem with the individual, you know, because look at anything that we have. There's always going to be that percentage of people that either abuse it or they're just stupid, and you know, there's going to be that small percentage. I mean, alcohol is still legal, and there's still people that drink themselves to death and act stupid, and it's a detriment to your life and your health. But it's legal, and people do it, and that's fine. You know, there's bad drivers. There's people that drive drunk. Should we outlaw cars? No. There's just going to be that percentage of idiots. And then, you know, the argument that, oh, it's distracting and it's consuming people's time. The same people that are there on it all day are the same people that if Pokemon Go wasn't there are the same people that would be on Facebook or Instagram anyway. They'll still be buried in their phone. They're just doing something different. None of that holds weight, in my opinion. If you let your kid walk into the street and get hit by a car, I mean, that's on you, not to be honest. You know, you gotta, that's all based on the individual and how you treat this thing, because the same person that's dumb enough to do that will be dumb enough to do something else, you know. That's not a fault of the actual game or the application. Now, the positives are ridiculous because I'm seeing something I've never seen before. You know, I've made it a habit lately to take a walk in my neighborhood, and I've been doing these like 30-minute walks just to get exercise, you know, just to enjoy the weather. And I'm seeing something I haven't seen in the last like 15, 20 years. There's kids outside interacting and playing. There's a church a few blocks from my house that's like a gym, I guess. I don't know how it works, but it's a place where everybody's gathering, and I'm seeing kids of all ages on bikes, and they're traveling on bikes, and I'm seeing teenagers and even 18, 19-year-olds meeting up with friends and going on bike rides, and they're outside. They're not indoors playing video games. They're not doing anything destructive. Like, they're interacting. People are outside, and adults also, you know, and it's crazy that a mobile app or a game was able to bring people outside because people just don't go outside anymore. People don't interact. Kids aren't playing in the streets anymore. You know, any time of day you go by that church and there's people hanging out, talking, and there's people coming in, bike riding back and forth. You know, I never thought I'd see that. You know, and I'm seeing even like, you know, different walks of life, you know, from different neighborhoods doing the same thing. And even in the city, and my coworkers, you know, people that would otherwise at the end of the day be like, all right, I'm done, let me go home and eat dinner and go to bed. They're like, you know, no, I'm gonna take a walk to 42nd Street just to see what's going on there, or I'm gonna take a walk 10 blocks down here. And at the end of the day, you're getting exercise, you're interacting, you're enjoying the weather, you're enjoying the summer. It was brilliant bringing it out in the summertime. And, you know, there's interaction. That's basically what it is. And it's face-to-face interaction. It's not, you know, Snapchatting or Facebook or whatever. Like, people are meeting people face-to-face and giving advice and things like that. So, is the game flawed? Yeah, I don't like it. I think it's cheesy, and maybe it'll get better down the line. It's got problems, it's got issues, so there's issues with the game itself. Sure, whatever. That's if you're just reviewing it from that aspect. But as far as the pros, it is definitely more of a pro than a con. So again, I don't play it, but I just wanted to say that. I think that overall it's a good thing. And as long as it keeps getting people out of their house and walking and interacting and getting exercise and bike riding, then let them enjoy their fun. And for that percentage of people that just are hating it because they don't understand it, then whatever. You know, it's just like, you know, there's a thing happening and I don't understand it, I don't like it, so it's stupid. You know, there's always going to be that crowd. So they're going to feel that way regardless. Don't let them stop you. If you're a Pokemon Go player, enjoy it. Enjoy it. Have fun. Go get some fresh air. I'm done. Later, y'all.